Cupid Copeland,
and we're here at the Genesis Cinema for the UK movie premiere of the movie Sparkle.
Urban Screen and Buff have teamed up to put on this fabulous event tonight,
and we here at Play Vibes and ViewNowTV.co.uk want to show you what went on.
Sister, you're going to marry this man. He disrespects our home. The Reverend.
Oh, he's a comedian. He's just trying to make me laugh. He's a really good man. He even goes to church sometimes.
Right. It is raw material, but I am there, and God knows my heart.
He ties.
Child, I don't think enough of you to introduce you to dentists and doctors and accountants. But no, not you. You want a whore with this coon.
So here I am tonight with John Janae Adelaide of X Factor fame. How excited are you here tonight to see the premiere of the movie Sparkle?
I'm really excited, mainly because of Whitney Houston, obviously. The first film I saw her in was Bodyguard. I thought she was amazing in that. You know, who knew she could act so well and, you know, just give that presence to camera that she does on, you know, on the records and everything. So, you know, what an amazing actress.
We all know that she is a fabulous actress. Would you expect the same level of, you know, prestige and status and the high level that she's set from the Bodyguard fame in this movie here tonight?
I think so. But I've come to learn over the years not to expect too much from things. You know, I put, you know, expectations of things when I was younger and was very disappointed in things. I won't say any names or any films or anything that's come up. But, you know, that's something I've had to learn over the ages. So I reserve judgment to see what comes. I can't imagine it was anyway bad, but you know, we're about to see it.
It's best not to mention names. You don't want to get in trouble, don't you? No,
exactly.
Yeah. Exactly. Keep things just nice and smooth. Nice and smooth. So as I mentioned, you know, you are well known for your stint on X Factor. Would you ever consider taking part in a musical film like this one?
Definitely. When I was in my teens, I did a lot of musical theatre. I did Little Shop of Horrors and Bugsy Malone and things like that.
Were you good?
I don't know. Again, reserve judgment for those who had seen it and they can tell you what happened. But I enjoyed the run. You know, I played Audrey too and did the whole plant thing, singing and acting at the same time. I thought it was amazing. And I spent a lot of time on my music. So I think I'm due a role somewhere in the world, you know, do some casting and hopefully see me on a stage or, you know, on camera somewhere.
And Jordan Sparks, who plays the title role, she actually has said that she wasn't expecting to get the lead role because, of course, as we know, she is a great songstress. You know, would you think that you're better as an actor? You know, you've got your, you know, debut in Little Shop of Horrors. Would you consider acting as well, seeing as you're established in your singing world?
I think so, but with acting, it's a very, you know, it's a small world, and there's a lot of people competing for positions and roles and things like that, you know. And I think when I was younger, I always looked at actors like Morgan Freeman as a real big inspiration, because I don't think he really started the big time until he was a lot older, you know. And acting is one of those things, no matter how old you are, there's always a role out there for you. So, you know, I reserve judgment again. I'll see what happens. Watch this space.
And talking about the film itself, it grossed over $11 million on its opening weekend over in the US and Canada. Do you think it can reach similar success over here in the UK?
Not so much, no, to be honest with you, mainly because it's a smaller market. You know, the UK, you know, how many people in the country now? What, 60 million or so? You know, it's like, and out of all those people, in today's world, we have social media, we have so many different avenues for people to go and kind of get what they really need, you know. So it's a genre-specific sort of film now, you know, and it doesn't have the massive push that it probably did in America and in Canada. So I don't expect it to do that well. But if you look at the numbers and you look at how many people will go and see it, I think in terms of averages, I think it will do really well.
And lastly, I cannot leave this interview without turning the attention on you just a little bit. Well, you know, we really want to know what you're up to. When can we see you again?
Well, I'm currently, well, I've just finished actually recording my debut EP. It was going to be the album, and with what we've done, we've got a whole bunch of concepts which we're rolling onto. The first one's called I'm a Polaroid, which basically is this whole kind of snapshot, you know, idea of just, you know, don't take that picture and throw it away kind of vibe, you know.
Very creative. You were thinking outside the box there. I like what you've got going on.
So there's a lot of songs. I tell you stories. The music is very diverse. There's a bit of soul, there's a bit of rock, and there's a bit of me. So we're going to have some fun. Watch this space again.
And when can we expect to see that being dropped?
Polaroid will be available probably sometime in October 2012. So you can download it from all the sites. There's a video already available. If you go to YouTube / Janay Baby, that's JNAYBABY. That's me. And and you can cop the video, which is I'm a Polaroid.
Fabulous. Thanks for chatting to us here tonight.
Very welcome. Take care.
Hi, I'm Siobhan Copeland. I'm here with Play Vibes Radio. I'm here with Jazz from The Voice, who we've seen on our TV screens quite recently. How are you doing?
I'm doing fantastic. I'm excited.
Yes? It is, isn't it? I mean, how did you feel about the whole, you know, was you a big Whitney Houston fan yourself?
Whitney was what made me. How do I say that? Between her and Mariah, they dominated my house, my speakers. So I don't think I could do what I could do if it wasn't for people like Whitney being here. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah. Absolutely.
If she wasn't around, do you know what I'm saying? I don't think I could do what I could do. Do you know what I mean?
So you'd say that Whitney and Mariah, and is like Michael Jackson, for example, an influence of yours as well within your music?
Michael Jackson is... I don't think there's anybody that can say that he isn't an influence. Of, you know what I mean? There's certain iconic people on this earth. You know what I mean? And Whitney was definitely one of them for me, in a way.
Yeah, absolutely. So do you think it's going to be quite emotional for you to see her on the screen this evening?
Definitely. I mean, I love Whitney as not only just as a singer, I love her as an actor. I love waiting to see a great film.
Me too.
You know what I mean? So, I mean, I know this film's going to be epic. So, me and my wife have spoken about it a lot. So, we're here, we're excited, we can't wait to see what Whitney pulls out. Do you know what I mean? We can't wait to see. I'm hearing CeeLo Green's in the film. I didn't know he was in the film. He's in the film. And I also heard there's an original. I didn't know that.
What's that? An original?
There's an original Sparkle.
I didn't know that either,
actually. I didn't
know that either.
Something new today? You learn new things.
When did you hear that? Was that been out for quite a while, is it? Or
what, Sparkle? Well, I literally just found out. I did another interview and they told me, have you seen the original one?
I didn't know that at all.
I didn't know
that. So is it kind of like the Dream Girls type of thing, where like they had a previous Dream Girls, didn't they?
That's what I'm thinking it might be. I mean, I love Dream Girls. Anything like that. Singing, anything creative, I'm involved.
Yeah, so. Absolutely. Do you think maybe this might have the potential to kind of go onto theatre screens, like as you know, Dreamgirls became a musical? Do you think this potentially could have a success because of, obviously, you know, with the sort of legacy of Whitney as well, that potentially, and if it were, would it be something you'd like to be involved in?
Oh yeah, definitely. I mean, the fact that it's got Whitney is enough for me.
I love it. You're sold.
Sold. Whitney's in it, so. But it needs to. It needs to be in cinemas and theatres all around. So I'm excited.
Absolutely.
I know I'm going to see something great today.
Yeah, I think we can all agree that we're definitely going to see something great. And obviously in the US, it came out a couple of months ago and it's seen, you know, amazing success there. Grossed over, I think, $1 million in the box office. Wow. I mean, do you think it's going to have the same kind of success here in the UK? Do you think it's going to be as well received and as popular here in the UK?
You know what? I want it to. I hope it will. I mean, the US is the US, and they're miles ahead of us musically. Let's keep it real. But I believe that there will be a change, and I think that maybe on this occasion it will. It will break sales and stuff. Do you know what I mean? June Girls did very well over here.
Yeah.
So I want it to. Do you know what I mean? It's Whitney.
Exactly. We're all rooting for Whitney.
It's Whitney. You have to.
And so what are you up to these days? Obviously, we've seen you recently, as I say, on The Voice, and you made Will I Am cry on The Voice. So how are things going for you now? What's the kind of plan, the next step for you now?
Well, I'm in studio a lot. I'm doing a lot of recording and writing, loads of writing sessions. My time is, I'm full-time music now, so if I'm not writing, I'm gigging. If I'm not gigging, I'm being a dad.
Oh, you're a dad too?
Oh, yeah. His name's Brandon. He's beautiful. Oh, and I'm always tired.
Is he a newborn? Or
newborn.
Oh, congratulations.
Thank you. He's going on 4 months now, but I'm tired all the time. But you know,
yeah, that's a full-time job in itself, isn't it?
Definitely. No complaints, really. But in regards to my music, I've got some singles. I'm very excited for the nation to hear it. I want the nation to hear my stuff very soon. The thing's moving slowly but surely. Do you know what I'm saying? So,
and are you working with anyone that we know, sort of producer wise, or any other? Are you co-writing with any other songwriters?
I'm doing loads of writing with many different producers and songwriters. Working with Ali, Ali Tennant. Done some stuff with, gosh, I just can't pull it off my head.
And do you kind of set your sights on, you know, going to the US and kind of, is that kind of the goal for you? Or are you kind of going to focus on the UK first and sort of?
Well, you know what, they say, I mean, I want to go to the US anyway, because the US is amazing, and I'm sure they get my music a little bit more.
Yeah.
But they say, try to conquer the ground that you're on before you just fly away. Do you know what I mean? So.
Yeah.
I'm believing in change. I'm hoping that the UK is becoming a bit more open, I believe. So I'm going to try hit here first.
Well, we hope that you wish you all the best, and we hope you enjoy the movie tonight. So, and hopefully we'll see some of your views on Twitter. Will you be taking to Twitter after the film tonight to let people know what you thought?
Definitely, I will definitely be taking to Twitter. No problem.
Excellent. It's been a pleasure to meet you, Jazz.
Pleasure to meet you.
And you've been listening to Play Vibes, so yeah, keep in touch.
So here I am with Jamie Archer. Jamie, how are you, my good sir?
I'm very well, thank you. I've just come out of the studio, so I'm a little bit. One minute I'm listening to guitar sounds, the next minute I'm at a premiere, so I'm a little bit out of sorts, but I'm okay.
Well, saying that, I think it could be fairly emotional watching the film. You know, as we know, the late Whitney Houston stars in the movie, and expectations are high. We know her acting capabilities, of course, in the Bodyguard movie, yeah. And just the fact whereby she's no longer with us anymore. Do you think you might be shedding a few tears there in the cinema?
I mean, yeah, I mean, of course it will be, because she's a legend, and she's a legend that, in the truest sense of the meaning, because she'll be remembered forever, and she'll not just because we kind of live in a very celebrity-based age these days, where people are famous for just being famous. She's from an era where she was famous for a reason, and that was her incredible voice, and she had charisma oozing out of every pore of her body. And I got to meet her for a very short period of time on The X Factor.
What?
Yeah. Oh. Yeah.
Did you actually exchange words with her?
Yeah. We did a thing called a masterclass, and that was, yeah. And so we'd all go up, and like we were going to the death or something, when it's like, right, go, and everyone's scared, and they're going up there, and they go and talk to her, and I'm a rock singer. She doesn't like my voice. I knew I was going to the gallows, because I was like, I'm singing it, and all this. She's like, yeah, good, man.
Were you scared to have eye contact with her?
Well, yeah, because one of my favourite songs of all time is One Moment in Time. And I mean, I can honestly tell you that I Will Always Love You is not going to be in my Desert Island disc. I'm a rock guy, okay? But I have to say that song is an inspiration to me as a songwriter, as a person. And there was a performance that you can see on YouTube, and that is of her doing it at the Grammys. acts off the chart. It's mind-blowing. She's another level. And so that's why seeing her in what is going to be, you know, the end, I guess, is it's going to be emotional, I think, for everyone.
Vibes Radio. I'm here with the lovely Chucky Venn. Chucky, you've just arrived, so I'm sorry I had to grab you immediately. Are you looking forward to tonight's movie?
Very much so. I'm elated. I'm excited, you know. And especially as this is, you know, one of Whitney Houston's last efforts on screen. You know, yeah, feel kind of privileged, a bit privy. You know what I mean? I feel a bit privileged and privy to bear witness to, you know, her last and perhaps maybe her greatest performance. Yeah, very much.
So I guess you saw Bodyguard and Waiting to Exhale. Are you expecting the same kind of success as we saw with those other films that Whitney was in?
Absolutely. I mean, let's be honest, you know, often the case, posthumous performances tend to sometimes be the most successful, or they usually sell well because of that. But because she was such a talented woman, gifted woman, you know, as an actress and of course as a singer, I expect her to do very, very well, you know. So I'm really, you know, I feel real privileged, like I said, to get this sort of advanced screening before it's officially released, you know, nationwide. Yeah.
Absolutely. Yeah. Do you think it's going to be quite emotional for, you know, fans of Whitney to see the film tonight as well? Do you feel like you're going to feel a little bit emotional? Are you a big Whitney fan yourself?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, like I said before, you know, we most of us grew up with Whitney Houston. You know what I mean? Even if you didn't like her, there's no way you could avoid those beautiful, entrancing tones, you know, that would emit from her mouth. You know, this was a very gifted woman, and despite all her frailties and her faults, she was somebody that you couldn't help but love. Do you know what I mean? You know, we always wanted to see her win, you know, and it's because of that she's so endearing to our hearts, you know. And even the children of today, they'll be able to relate and I think fall in love with her, you know what I mean? So yeah, I think I will be emotional effectively when we do watch it. I don't know if I'll cry. Maybe I will. I don't know. I mean, you know, I consider myself a sensitive person. So, yeah, you never know.
That's a very poetic tribute there, I must say.
Thank you, man. You know, come on. You know, when you have somebody, like I said before, so talented and gifted as Whitney Houston, she brings out that, I guess, poetical side in you. You know what I mean? Straight. I feel I'm an emotional person, like I said before. So if I'm driven to just emote and express myself, that's what comes out, you know? But yeah, man, yeah, it's a beautiful thing, honestly, it's a beautiful thing. And to see so many people out here, like I said before, I know I'm sure equally as excited as I am to just see, you know, this performance on her. It's lovely.
You're in EastEnders, so we kind of keep in touch with you there. Are you going to be tweeting or anything about tonight's...
Of course, I'm going to be tweeting as soon as I come off this interview. I'm going to be tweeting, man, absolutely, you know. And make sure, you know, Sparkle gets as much exposure as possible. Yeah.
And do you think, finally, I mean, in terms of obviously, you know, sort of urban films and things like that, do you feel like urban actors and artists are getting a lot more recognition now? Do you think that it's kind of improving? And do you think this is, you know, something which is going to kind of, obviously recently, like with the music thing, we've seen a lot more urban acts in the charts and things like that. But urban films have maybe not been getting as much exposure. Do you think that now that's kind of changing and that, you know, that's going to be the way forward for UK actors and artists?
Very much so. You know, it's obviously a work in progress. And, you know, work in progress is very arguable. That's a subjective expression when you say work in progress, because that work in progress could take a short period of time or a long period of time, you know? And I'm a strong believer of it's not how you start a race, but it's how you finish. And right now, we're racing, we're in this race. And yeah, they're bringing out some good quality stuff, you know? It's not so much about the quantity, it's about quality. That's what it's all about. Yeah. And yeah, I think there's definitely room for improvement, and we are constantly improving with it. Yeah, absolutely. Brilliant. 100%.
Well, it's been an absolute pleasure to meet you today, Chucky. And I hope you enjoy the movie. And I'll be looking out to see if you're crying in the audience. I know I will be. I'll pass you a hanky.
Oh, you do that, man. I'll be looking out for you too, you hear? Looking out for this fluffy little fluffy leather jacket.
I'm Siobhan Copeland. This is Chucky Venn. This is Play Vibes. Thanks for listening.
So here I am with Owen Lewis, OBE. How are you tonight, my good sir?
I'm good. I'm enjoying it. Lovely people, lovely surroundings and a very special event. And we're just glad to be invited to come here and witness the legend that is Miss Whitney Houston, to pay homage to her last public persona, as we will, you know, as we will see on film. And it's good to be here to see this tonight and to be part of it. And the title is actually quite appropriate because she sparkled. That's what she did in her life. She sparkled. And very appropriate title. And she's handing the baton on to her co-star, you know, to go forward and she's showing, in a way it's eerie because she's showing her the ropes of what the pitfalls of what's in life. And it's sort of fact and fiction blurring. And but I'm just glad to be here to be part of this and to, as part of what we do, the ACLT, raising awareness and saving lives. It's and inspiring and motivating is what Whitney's was about, is about, what we're about.
Definitely. So, you know, your organisation, the ACLT, has such a strong presence within the black community. And, you know, our black community, we are strong. We are a strong community. Do you think that, you know, our community can support, you know, black films, especially black films released here in the UK? Because, you know, as I've mentioned before to other people, this film, Sparkle, did so well over in the US and Canada, and people are sceptical if it can reach the same success over in the UK. What do you think?
We can, and I like to think we will. We've just got to, one by one, word of mouth, support, use the social media to put the message out about how we need to support each other. Because if we don't, no one else will. And we can do that, but as we find with our community, you have to sometimes dig a bit deeper to get the same reaction. But once you hit that mine of good wishes and that positivity that is always there, everyone else, watch out, stand back, because we blow everyone away and everyone wants to copy us afterwards. We just have to look inside our heart and souls and realize we are the original. Everyone else is trying to copy us. Let us show what we're about and let us support our own, and we can do so as well as anyone else. We just got to believe in ourselves more, because everyone else does, we just don't believe in ourselves enough. And when we do, watch out.
And I don't know if you've seen any of the trailers, if you know anything about the film, but do you have any expectations of the movie you're about to watch?
I got an open mind. I've been sort of looking forward to seeing this, because it's fiction following fact, or vice versa, because of what happened with Whitney Houston. And I'm looking forward to this because I want to pay testimony and tribute to this fabulous lady who had her faults, but actually she had a purity of soul coming from a gospel background that transcended everything and actually made a lot of difference to a lot of people out there. And I want to pay tribute to this fantastic lady and what she represents and will continue to represent. And I've got an open mind, but I know afterwards I will be saying to people, I think you need to go and watch this film, support it.
I hope your expectations are met here tonight. Go and enjoy the movie. Thanks for joining me here tonight, Oren.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, I like that. Make you
want to
dance.
So here I am, joined with Ashley and Glenn from Twist and Pull. So how are you guys tonight?
We're very well, thanks. Great. How are you?
I'm very well. Thank you for asking. You care? I'm feeling the love here on the sofa. So, guys, what are you expecting from tonight's movie?
Some amazing vocals. Yeah. Like, we love people that can sing.
Yeah.
So and Whitney Houston is like,
and I go, and we're just gonna go
like in unison, like synchronized,
yeah.
And everything.
Synchronized, yeah.
Okay, so we know you for the dancing. So are you not expecting a bit of dance moves here in the film?
We are expecting.
I'm
dance
expecting,
moves.
But if there isn't, I won't be upset. As long as they're singing, I'll be happy.
Yeah,
I think.
And what about, you know, Whitney Houston and Jordan Sparks, the two, you know, two of the lead actresses in the movie? How excited are you guys to see them on screen?
Whitney, she's back. Whitney. She's back to perform for us. Like, what's better than that?
Yeah, and it's obviously her latest film since she sadly passed away. So, like, we're so ready to see what she had to offer in this kind of time now.
And lastly, what can we expect from you both? We miss you.
Oh, we miss you too.
Miss you.
Even though you've just met me?
Yeah.
Okay.
We'll miss you when we get off.
Yeah, we'll miss you when we leave.
Okay. Cool, I understand. What are you guys up to at the moment?
Yeah, we're doing loads at the moment. We're working on an online series, which we're going to be doing soon. We're also doing workshops all over the UK. So we're just getting out to all the schools, dance companies and stuff like that, and spreading street dance and comedy everywhere we can.
Yeah.
We've got a film we're working
2013.
So,
really?
Yeah, don't tell anyone.
Okay.
Maybe we're next to you at the premiere of that. Yeah.
Are you going to put me on the guest list?
Yeah.
Okay, wicked. I'm there. Definitely. I'm there. Well, go and enjoy the movie, guys. Oh, thanks for joining me here on the sofa.
Cheers. Thank bye. You.
I'm Siobhan Copeland, and this is Play Vibes Radio, and I'm here with the very talented Michael O. Welcome.
Hello, thank you. Thanks for having me.
Very welcome. So, Michael, what have you been up to recently? Obviously, you're known for being in the kind of in the gospel fields. So, what have you been up to at the moment?
What haven't I been up to? I've been up to loads. So, my TV show, The One to One Show. This year we decided to syndicate it all over the world, so we are in over 60 countries now around the world. Jamaica is premieres next week. New Zealand actually premiered today, which is awesome. So if you're watching from New Zealand, good stuff. Grenada is this weekend. We're all over Africa.
I'm half Grenadian, so
put it there. There you go.
All right.
Well, so we're all over the Caribbean. We're all over Africa. We're looking to get into Northern America by the end of the year as well. So there's loads going on.
The gospel, you know, music, that's where her roots are, you know, in the gospel field. So it's kind of like, I think every gospel artist can probably note Whitney as one of their influences.
Absolutely. And she was very, I'm good friends with great artists like B.B. Winans and Donnie McClurkin, and they were really close friends with Whitney Houston, and they speak of her very affectionately. From what I heard of her, she was someone who liked to help all of them, and she pulled them close, even down to, you know, paying for their tours when they didn't have any money. So she was not only just a big icon, but she was very dear to those who knew her.
Yeah.
So yeah, it's a big loss. It's a big loss, but we get to relive her. We get to relive her legacy tonight at the premiere. So really looking forward to that.
Absolutely. So do you think that the film, it's obviously very successful in the US. Do you think it's going to be as successful here in the UK?
I pray it is, because it's got Whitney Houston, one of the biggest, the queen of pop. You know, he doesn't really get any bigger than that. It's got Jordan Sparks, which is, you know, who's another awesome artist who's doing great, great here in the UK. It was produced by one of the biggest bishops in the world, Bishop T.D. Jakes. And we over here in the UK are all around to supporting him. You know, I've been tweeting about it all day. Well, since the movie came out, even before it came to the UK, I've been tweeting about it.
Yeah.
And so I hope it really does get the right distribution to get into the right cinemas. I think people will go out and support, and I pray they do.
Yeah, I mean, she's obviously got a lot of fans here in the UK too.
Absolutely, absolutely. Both Jordan and Whitney are very... They've got big followings over here. Not to talk about the likes of CeeLo Green and all the others who are making appearances in the movie. So it's a big film. There's no reason why it shouldn't do as good in the UK. So yeah.
Yeah, definitely. Are you going to be featuring about the film as well on your particular show?
You put me on the spot now. We're actually planning to do something with Jordan Sparks in November. So. Yeah. Hopefully she's going to give us a bit more insight into the show. So look out for that coming in season 4.
Excellent. Well, I think the film's about to start in a few moments' time. So with no further ado, but thank you for giving us your time and this evening. So what's the best way to stay in touch with you? Obviously you mentioned Twitter there. So what's your Twitter address?
My Twitter is MichaelOTV. So it's the letters OTV. You can visit my website. It's www.officialmichaelo.com. O is just the letter O. Nice and simple.
Fantastic. Thanks for joining us this evening, Michael. Thanks for listening.
more raw, more relatable. A film over here, we come. Now, of course, you're going to have to work with Bells.
You have to be invited to convene.
Yeah, no, I'll work on that. I want you to work with your sisters, and I'll work on Cliff Bells.
And you'll be our manager?
Of course.
Then you manage to get my sisters.
Do I have you?
Back up, remember?
Sparkle is in cinemas nationwide now.
Make sure you check it out.
We've been Play Vibes Radio with funaltv.co.uk.
Keep it locked.